This is Eco Mao, the one and only black cowboy with a story. Vote like a post. Ah, love you, Madonna. Yeah. You may not know this, but in reggae music, there a lot of racism, white supremacism, bias, bigot. Some people are reprehensible. We're gonna talk about the business aspect of the reggae music. You know what I'm saying? Whereas three Jamaican does not control the reggae business. Friends and enemies in high places, he come out. Banding the money. Oh yeah. In the year 2000, Mr. Gary Fogner summoned me to the Coach House nightclub in San Juan Capistrano. Say, Mouth, I want to be a manager. Say, okay. Say, Mouth, you're a spendthrift. I can spend money. He called a friend named Robert Fitzpatrick. But Mr. Robert Fitzpatrick was the president of Allied Artists, managed The Who, Taj Mahal, Bee Gees, was one of the lawyers for the Beatles. One of the lawyers for the Beatles. The Mouth. I always have the Beatles up front, my office. And I place you right there. Place me right there, nigga. Long time wanna kill you. Mm-hmm. That's what he did. And they say, Mouth, I'm gonna sign you. I'm gonna sign you. Let me reiterate. You say, Mouth, I wanna sign you. Hey man, I'm talking on the shit, man. Get a shot. Some Jamaican talking shit. Weed smoke. Get a shot. Anyway, said you want to sign Mouth to a 4-year contract deal. Mouth, you're going to take your assets. Blah, blah, blah. But during that time, I was with Mr. Tim McClure. Mr. Tim McClure, MC Eduwari. First name Tim. Mm-hmm. Palm Springs, California. Mr. Mouth, I built a Coach House. Gary and I are friends. Mr. Gary Fogner. Well, the Coach House was like in the middle between San Diego and Los Angeles. So one day, I sat in his office. I said, Gary, how about having your own label? Coach House label. So I said, yeah. You can formulate that shit. Said, okay. He said, why is that, Mouth? I said, at the Coach House, B.B. King, Willie Nelson, Jimmy Cliff, Yellow Man, he come on, we all played it. What about having a compilation CD? Oh, Mouth, good idea. Bam! Got the stuff going on. We got Coach House record. But I never knew this guy was so reprehensible, a racist. He was a racist. You, Gary Fogner, Coach House record. At 70 years old, he ain't got no children. Now, my white baby mom, she flying. Wanna pick her up? When they saw how beautiful that white bird was, they were fucking jealous. Mm-hmm. It's a Mouth, we're gonna get to your house. They will get me in every house, there's a Mouth, you come out, so you ain't got no house. Mm-hmm. Gary Fogner, Robert Fitzpatrick. We're gonna talk about Olivia Chaston from VP Records, who begged me to distribute for them in Brazil. I did. Got two guys signed. They got me out. Their house kicked me out. Mm-hmm. And there can be more about Tim McClure, who was Gary Fogner's friend, sent on tour to collect mouth money. 250 shows a year I did in America. Mm-hmm. Call them some mouth. You can make it famous. Famous? Why you make me famous? So they took all of my stuff. Mm-hmm. I was gonna tell you about Jim Buss, the co-owner of the Los Angeles Lakers basketball team. We marched backstage in 2007. Said, Mouse, I wanna be a manager. Gonna buy your house and a car. Jim Buss, he did that. We got witness. Alex Walker, Scorpio, Mark Ray, everybody were there. And you, it has to be racism. At school, I got two Lexus. The LF430 and LF470. Each car valued $70,000 US. But paying notes gave to me by Mr. Joe Pistano. Mr. Joe Pistano warned me, say, Mouth, I don't trust Fitzpatrick. I don't trust Fogner. He's a white man. Italian. Frank Sinatra. The Frank Sinatra godson. Mm-hmm. Tim McClure, friend. Yep. I should have followed him. I said, go, my friend. Now, after a few years, Joe Pistano said, Mouth, I'm going to leave Lexus. Call Joe Pistano. Has the biggest Lexus dealership in Tustin, California. He said, Mouth, I'm gonna leave that company. He did. And go to Audi and rebuild Audi. Anything that going on right now with Audi, in them James Bond movie, was renovated by my friend, Joe Pistano. Mm-hmm. Yeah, high and mighty. So I'm in the big league. In the Distinguished League of Gentlemen. Mm-hmm. The story of my American family. Oh yeah. Tyrone Shackleton. Joseph Ripton Hilton. Ripton Joseph Hilton III. Heflin Hilton and Yishka Hilton. Bang, 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 then. Racism. Got out your father. Mm-hmm. So absurd, disdain, reprehensible, these narcissistic sociopaths. Now, this chick was sent. Her name was Rebecca Ann Wills. Never had a pot to pee in. Mm-hmm. I was with a woman, belly dancer. She didn't care. So while I was stationed at a Scandal nightclub, Mr. John React, say, Mouse, leave that white girl alone. She's undesirable. She's not 19. Didn't know. Thought he was jealous. He sold me a fake ID. Yep. That's how it is. Never knew she was kicked out of her house by her parents. How she busted her father's head with a stone. How her mother and father were racist. Mm-hmm. But she tried to hurt them by only dating black men. Mm-hmm. What she did. This chick, Rebecca Ann Wills, hot, pretty white girl, pretty white bird. They say the white boys hate that. See me and them pretty black, white birds flocking together. Mm-hmm. Now, she got pregnant. She used some paraphrase or some subliminal message. As we left the Moonlight Beach Lodge in Carbon, said, baby, I'm pregnant. What should I do? What should I do? Abortion, abortion, you got to have caution. I said, no, bring the child come. And she did. At a time, she was separated by her parents, who had nothing to do with her, because since he busted her father's head with a stone, they were estranged from each other. Her father sent her to jail, sent her in a drug rehab, and all that love we had, she lied. But the kid, the Messiah, Turan Yishtak Hilton. I gave him that name when Yishtak Rabin was assassinated. And during that time, it was alleged that O.J. Simpson killed his wife, Nicole Simpson. There is no way out after doing 9 years out of a 33 year sentence. When Turan born, his grandmother didn't care about him. Didn't give a hell about that daughter. Your daughter hate you. Yeah, Rebecca, you hate your parents. I was the one. You say, you know what? Honor thy mother and thy father. And that day shall be longer. Shouldn't do that. The evil. When Turan was born, a gem. At 3 years old, he was reading fluently, children encyclopedia. 5 years old, took him to school. He got the best of both sides. Any child or children can learn. You don't want to know that they're in the best community. Yep. 5 years old, skip kindergarten. First grade. While in first grade, doing 12th grade mathematics. Took me to school. The teacher, they hate me. Because Turan Yishtak Hilton was the brightest, smartest kid in school. So, Daddy, I want to be on TV. So I called John Robert Powers, acting school agent. Less than 1 month, he was on national TV. Serena Williams, the tennis player. Mouse, can I have your son? Should I take her number? That was, yep. Turan, smart. So it was so reprehensible, absurd, disdain, all these narcissistic sociopaths trampled on me. I was in pain. In my own house, I was a slave. Now, they barred me from America illegally when they took all my money. I was making over 6 figures per year. A month, I beg your pardon, as I reiterate, 6 figures over 100,000. And during that time, they took my stuff from me. Gary Emafarb from the coach house was sending Rebecca Andrews my money. That's why they switched to Florida. Now in Florida, the law school is so difficult to take somebody's house money from them. This is the reason why O.J. Simpson is out of prison in October. But the Florida situation, they don't want him in Florida. You know why? For O.J. Simpson, in that civil account, civil lawsuit, over $30 million. So he has some money in his pocket, about $9-10 million. They want to take it from O.J. So if he is stationed in Florida, they can't take it. That's why Rebecca Ann Wells took my kids to Florida with her broke-heart parents who live in Ocean City, Maryland. And let me tell you something. She paraded my children in front of Makeda Dredd. Making my calls in San Diego and say, I come out. Abandon my children. Never. She did that. Them white boys told her what to do. So she must be some white supremacist. Have been through racism. The guy said, Mouse, I'm get your house to rent. 11 months, No, officer, man. Yeah, last thing going on. The case of Amanda Rudder. Mm-hmm. After, but I use a rubber. Bang, then, gone, then. Then. Oh, yeah. In the year 2010, it was alleged that I would been charged for rape and kidnapping a woman sent by the white supremacy. Her name was Amanda Rudder. Mm-hmm. Yep. She was sent by this white boy who she robbed. Drugs and money in the car. She was sent. Oh yeah. She was asking for me one day before the concert. Mm-hmm. That's how it is. Yeah. My friend, since I was 10, Bob Marley, the untold story. Mm-hmm. You torture him. Mm-hmm. Cut out his locks. Cut out his larynx. Mm-hmm. And his pharynx. Mm-hmm. And they cut out them teeth. Mm-hmm. Kill the Rasta man. Rasta man vibration. All right now. Me and the Marlies go way back. I'm 10 years old. The house where I live, it's 167 Greenwich Park Road. Next door, the house that Rita Marley lives. Mm-hmm. Anything about that. Now, Rita Marley wrote a book that Bob Marley raped her. How the hell are you gonna wait till Bob Marley passed away for 30 years? You're gonna write a book named No Woman to Cry. Because she did cry for the money. That's the only song that Bob Marley sang about. No woman no cry. No woman no cry. I remember when we used to sit in a government yard in Trenton. Now she knew he was on his dying bed. But Bob Marley's heart was pure and clean. Mm-hmm. So she reminded him. And in due time, Bob Marley got other chicks. Mm-hmm. You know who Bob Marley loved? I don't wanna wait in vain for your love. Cindy Breakspear, Miss World, our girl, Bob Marley, love her. She should get the money. Now, let me tell you something. How you doing now? I'm a tough guy. Rita Marley stormed out with half of her Rasta hair dread. She's cussing Bob Marley. Yes, Rita, I was right there. Me, Lip, Tony Welch, and my friend named Stero, who became the American Most Wanted. Mm-hmm. Up there with General Starkey, Anthony Tingle, Natty Chris, a pure bad boy, Bob Marley hanging. Me a rude boy. What would Bob Marley say? He come out, take care of my kids. Mm-hmm, sing for them. Mm-hmm. Turn the lights down low. He's talking about Cindy Breakspear. 3 years knocking at your door, and I take a knock for more. Mm-hmm. Ooh, girl. Mm. You see, Bob never knew he was gonna die. 36 years old. Did you know that Rita Marley tried to upset Bob Marley by having sexual flirtation with a man called Stewie Dredd? Oh yeah, Bob Marley's best friend. That's why she get mad and storm downstairs, shouting, the is called Oh Miss World. Oh dear, you can call Miss World. Cindy makes me a bitch, you know. I mean, meet a man from Cuba, Cuban, easy. We're gonna send you back to Cuba. Anyway, she looked, or pointed her mouth upstairs and shouted, stairs, that Bob Malovic and the is having the devil's child. Them time Junior Gang was in his man's belly. The devil's child. Now, when Sidney Breakspear, Miss World, after a baby, she named him Damien Marley. Let me reiterate. Damien was about a child who was possessed by the devil. So by throwing back stuff, Aretha Marley, she named her child Damien. Let me tell you something, Junior Gang. At 12 years old, you sat beside me at 13. At the Starlight Theater in San Diego. You asked, he come out, mouth. Your lyrics so wicked, and cute, and nice. What you do it? Steve Marley asking me how to make lyrics. I said, watch here. Junior Gang. When you're in the studio, you have your lyrics. Yes, sir. After a while, you just put it aside. And you start to make two or three or different takes of pure freestyle. Well, I think Junior Gang said, yeah! I think I'm gonna say, yeah, man! I mean, yeah, Junior Gang, I mean, he come out. Mm-hmm. But he's intimidated by Steve Marley. Because Steve Marley always mouse, yeah, PNP. Junglist, oh yeah. In Jamaica, we are stigmatized where we're from. Not like a political. Did you know that Dennis Brown was Bob Marley's favorite singer? When I intercepted Ziggy Marley and asked him why he didn't brought Mr. D. Brown on tour, he said, out, what are you cracking? What? If he's a crackhead, rehabilitate him. Suck your man. In Jamaica, when you're born, you're like convicted of what you are. Yes, me a junglist, bad boy to the bone. Bob Marley did love the PNP party. Maybe I'm wrong. But at the time, he was best friend with Tony Welch, aka number one. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Mr. Lip on tour with him. Then he got Sonny. Which he brought on tour. I'm gonna die. No one knew that Bob was dead at 36. But let me tell you something. When Bob Marley went to Zimbabwe, didn't know. Entrapment. They invited Bob Marley in Zimbabwe. But Bob Marley never knew that. So anarchy going on, all kind of stuff. That Mr. Robert Mugabe was branded as the Black Hitler. It's the only flag with an AK-47 on it. Not in Dubiti, not Zimbabwe. Ayanaya Zimbabwe, Zimbabwe. Soon you will find out who is the real revolutionary. Because I don't want my people to trick by a mercenary. Brother, you're right, so right. We're gonna fight, fight for right. That statement that Bob Marley made. God almighty, the world wanna kill him for that. Rasta no work for no CIA, rat race. They found Bob Marley with some compromising position with Jim Brown. Storyteller. Now all them bad boys from the show passive. They want to interview Bob. So Bob said, we know where from the CIA. What did Bob say? He said, no matter, we're going to talk to the CIA. You remember back in the 50s, maybe 60s, when Frank Sinatra was summoned by the FBI because he took some photo with Joe Castellano, some badass Italian mafia, a country shit called Frank Sinatra. And President Kennedy, the best of friends, and Marilyn Monroe. Because it was Frank Sinatra who introduced Marilyn Monroe to the president. Man, you're a dog. I'm a good dog. Bow, wow, wow. Chicky, yow, chicky, yay. Mm-hmm. That's how it is. Mm-hmm. Let me go forward again. Are we going to tell you what happened?
African children, down in a situation. African children, I know where you're coming from. African children, coming home from school. Everybody eating from the same food. Situation so bad, yet they're happy and glad. African children, I know where you're coming from. Kunta Kinte children, I know where you're coming from. Shaka Zulu children.